Hi everyone, my name is Łukasz, and if you are into open networking like I am, welcome, you are in the right place. Today we are diving into the Edgecore AS4630 series. There are three models. Edgecore is using dual numbers. Let me try to bring that. So first model is non-PoE, so call it EPS201, also known as AS4630-5040. Second, it's EPS202, that one is bringing PoE, and the last one, bigger one, EPS203, also known as AS4630-5040 NP. If you watched Sebastian's earlier video, it will be here or there, you saw that he was presenting a previous series. They've been good for a basic 1G deployments, and they've been coming with the Trident3-X3 chipset. But what is special in that new 4630 models? They built on the Trident3-X3. This means better scale, better VXLAN support, and more switching power. There will be also a few other points which I will try to bring you. So let's open the box, see what you can get, and let's go through each model. So what is in the box? No matter which model you will choose, you will get a quick start guide, power cords, of course redundant, you have two, a console port, and all what you need to install that switch properly in the rack. Optional, you can also get like a toolless mounting rice like it. It is an accessory which you can get if you need to have more that type of server options of the mounting. Everything you need to get started and mount the switch right away. Let's begin with the first model, which is the non-PoE version. This is your go-to switch for the management network, data centers, also good for the enterprise environment or the campus deployment. On the float, we have 48x1G, RJ45, so basically similar as Sebastian was showing, but we have here more throughput. So the uplinks are not 10G, but 4x25G and 2x100G. With those 100G ports, you know the story, you can split them to 4x25 or 4x10G. You can also run it as a 40G if it is needed. On the back, we have two hot swappable AC PSUs. There are also three fans, 2+1 for the redundancy configuration. And the non-PoE model is coming with two airflow options, either the typical front to back or back to front. Inside, Broadcom Trident3-X3, 386 gig of the throughput, Intel Atom C3558, 60 gig of RAM, 32 of SSD, and of course it's coming with ONI, so it means that you can choose software if you wish. We have Sonic, we have BISDN, we have Arcus, we have PK8, and more. Handless VXLAN, IPv6, and VXLANs overlay. It's not a problem. Next, the EPS202. So this is the PoE version. SER port configuration like previously, but with a serious PoE power. So now all those 1G interfaces can support PoE++. This means that you can power it some devices up to 90 watts. And this is another the difference comparing to the series of AS4625. As you remember, that PoE version was coming with PoE plus support, but only the last 8 interfaces been capable to support ultra PoE. Here, every of those can support it. The budget is also powerful. We have 1.5 kilo of watts. It's ideal for really heavy hunger PoE devices. Airflow is only front to back, but perfect for most needs and rack setups. Inside, same story. Trident3-X3, Intel Atom, 60 gig of RAM, 32 SSD, full ONI support. But from the, you know, software support, you need to choose those ones which are capable to support PoE. It's great for your campus environment, some retail, and more. You saw we have finally a really nice three models. If we will take a look from the bottom of that stack, we have the non-PoE version, very solid switch, ideal for the data center management, enterprise environment, also campus where you don't need PoE. Second in the middle, full PoE, great for access points and edge power. And the one on the top, our beast with multi-gig, this is our most than high power, high speed, high flexibility. All those three models share same family, Trident3 X3 from the Broadcom side, same Intel Atom CPU. They are hot swappable with swappable fans and the power, and of course their support VXLANs. This is another big factor. So if we will summarize the difference between the previous series, uplinks, more throughput, more power, ultra PoE everywhere, and VXLANs. A few words about the warranty. So Edgecore is already providing a quite good warranty comparing to the competitors. It is 3 years back to the base. But if you need more, 5 or even more, which could be discussed case by case, we as a store disk can provide that under our open to support umbrella. But also if you would like to change that back to the base to more enterprise type of the warranties like advanced replacement, no problem, call us, we will sort it. So if this helped you hopefully to pick the right switch, give a big like. If you have a questions, drop it in the comment sections. I will try to personally reply on each of those. And if you love open networking, same as I do, hit subscribe. More reviews coming soon. Thanks for watching. And remember, Ethernet always wins. Thank you.